Hey guys, if you've just started using BeaTunes and you're a little bit confused about how to actually use this amazing piece of software, then you're in the right place because I spent a fair bit of time and wasted a whole heap of time not doing what I'm going to show you now. So there didn't seem to be too many tutorial videos that other people had put up online about BeaTunes, so I thought I'd make this one myself. So let's get to it. Essentially, BeaTunes is a pretty freaking amazing piece of software that helps you to completely categorize and organize your music library like never before, whether you need it for DJing or you need it for whatever, or you're just really fastidious like me. This is the way that I think that you can do it. And basically started, I found this program purely because I was wanting to fill the BPM column within iTunes so that I could know average songs. Obviously you can increase the BPM and decrease the BPM if you're DJing, but it's good to be able to, I think, still have a whole heap of songs that are at a similar BPM to sort of to mix together. So in a nutshell, you've got on the left-hand side over here, library, analysis, inspection, and charts. So we're going to start with library, and essentially you've got two different types of library that you can add to BeaTunes. So you go to file, you start at file and you go to new library. Now, if you use iTunes and you've already got an existing library that's connected with that, then you would click on iTunes based library. If you don't use iTunes and you've just basically got a directory based library, which means that you've just got a folder full of music that you've categorized in whichever way, shape or form you have, then you would use that one. So let's start with the iTunes one. With iTunes, you click on that. Now, what you're wanting here is that it automatically goes to the music folder on your computer and it opens up iTunes, right? Now, you're not going to click on one of these folders. You're going to click on this, iTunes Music Library.xml. This is the file that basically allows you to connect with iTunes, sync everything to a T, and it's epic. So you'd click on that and then you'd click OK. I'm not going to do it this time because I've already got my library here. Now, if you can't see that file there, what you need to do is you need to go back to iTunes, okay, and you need to go to Edit, Preferences, and make sure that this is ticked, Share iTunes Library XML with other applications, and then you'll be good to go. And then basically what you'll see here, these are all my playlists, all of these playlists and all of the songs, if I go back up to here, 42 genres, then all of this will look pretty much exactly the same until you start populating it in different ways here with all these colors and stuff. It'll look fairly similar on this side. Okay, so once you've done that, you're good to go with iTunes. If you don't have iTunes, you're gonna go to new library and you're gonna go to directory-based library. And this is where you specifically want to click on the folder that has your music. So if you're just wanting to categorize music, I'd go to music like that and then click on okay. Okay. That's it. Boom. That'll bring it in pretty quickly. Well, depending upon how much music you've got. I've got over 6,000 songs. It didn't take too long, less than a minute, which is great. Then you want to go to analysis. So analysis is epic. It basically allows you to completely fill a whole heap of information within each song that you just don't have. So you go up here to view. You go to tools and you go to analyze all songs. And now it's going to ask you what you want to tick off. What do you want it to actually analyze? The more of these things you tick off, the longer it's going to take. Okay. But as you can see here, there's specific ones that I just basically went down and had a look at each one and decided whether I needed it or not, because the description on the side there was pretty evident. One thing that I decided to do instead was when I imported metadata from online resources, I just imported missing data, instead of changing the genre and a whole heap of other things that I'd sort of worked pretty hard on doing over time. I still want to keep some of those different genres because, you know, like for example, with electronic dance music, there's a gazillion different types of genres, but there are certain ways you might look at music than others, and it might be you might prefer to have your own genre labeling. There's estimate BPM. I wanted that. Estimate danceability, instrumentation, mood, color. These are things that you should read on the side here to think if you want to use, but there are definitely other people talking about this stuff. And the BeaTunes website that you can find in the description on this YouTube video will also give you more detail about what all of these things do. So go and search for that to look at it and decide whether or not you want to do it. Plus, else, if you just want to copy what it is that I'm doing here, then feel free to do it. Last FM, all these different things. So then you click on analyze. So I'm not going to do that there now because same thing again, it's already done it on my side. But then what you'll see is you'll have a task queue. You'll have all of these different songs that you've got within your system will be there, and you'll see a green bar going across showing what progress is being made. And then you'll see each song slowly getting all of its things, all of its columns filled. So now another thing to know then here with this as well is once that's all done and within your library, you can change the columns that you want to see. So these are the ones that I've chosen to use, and you can move them around into whichever order that you want to move them around to. But if you right click on there or two finger on your mouse pad with Apple, then you can cruise through here and then just tick off all of the different things that you want to see. So there's an instrumentation one over here. If I turn that off, that goes away, but I want to put it back. Okay, so pretty simple with that. So it starts analyzing all of your different songs, and then what's going to happen is that two things are going to happen. You're going to see them come up in your library with all of these things filled out, and you're also then going to see this section here called the inspector start to pop up showing all of these problems that you might have with songs, albums, everything. Like this is the crux of what makes this thing really awesome. So when you're getting doubled up tracks and misspelt album names and different years and a whole heap of different things, this is pretty freaking cool. So to give you a bit of an example, when you go to library, this is what would have come up. So what about me? So say, for example, there's a lowercase a on what about me. The inspection is going to follow that up and it's going to ask you. It comes up really simply asking you how you would like to edit that particular song. How can I find a better friend? So it'll come up with the time. It's going to pop up with all this stuff, the BPM, the genre that I've put for it. Now, these things, color and mood, as you can see, you get a bit of an idea. All of these colors here, the RGB colors, are actually representative of the frequency of the music coming out of the speakers. So you'll tend to see that you're going to see a lot of similar colors for similar frequencies. So if I could find, for example, I'll just close that. If I can type in, I'm just going to type in a spoken voice one. This is all educational stuff. You can see it's all a similar green type sort of color. So I think we'll get used to that. I've only just started using this, but you'll get used to those colors and what they mean if you're wanting to, I guess, join songs in a DJ set, or if you're wanting to create new playlists out of similar songs. Same thing here with the moods, very aroused, angry. So obviously you can see I've got AC/DC songs and metal on the side here. So obviously the mood's going to be very different. Other things to help. Danceability as well. So I think the higher the number, the more danceable the song is. I think it goes up to 10. Don't quote me on that. I haven't fully used that yet, but a lot of the lower ones all seem to be metal based sort of stuff and have low danceability. Maybe there should be a headbanging column in there. Transition. This I thought was pretty cool. It basically talks about how within that one song, there's several color changes. All the mood changes, yeah, they're from very aroused and angry to very excited. And all the BPM changes a lot as well. So it can give you specifics about each song. These are tags, I think, that get pulled in from lastfm.com that let you know a little bit more about the type of music that it is. So I haven't added any of those tags, and it tells you the location of the file. So like that's all pretty freaking awesome. So what had happened then is that you go to inspection, and there's nothing coming up here at the moment. Let me even just see. If I go up to here and click on inspects the entire library, maybe you might be able to just inspect one song. Inspect. Has this come up there at all? Tap beat, no. Playing Firefox, no. Well, anyways, what you would do is you would click on that particular button. Actually, let's see if anything comes up. I'll just click on inspects the entire library. Misspelled artist. So it's going through, you can see there, and looking at all these different things. All right. So as you can see, there are some numbers that are popping up here. There's 7 within consistency issues. There might be some other ones that might come up in these other general sorting issues, all that sort of stuff. We'll see what happens. And whilst that's doing that, what am I What you also know then is that if I go back here to iTunes, any changes that you make in BeaTunes are actually going to reflect in here immediately, because you'll see a fair bit when the analyzing's all going on. You'll see this screen actually changing quite a lot. It'll keep flashing all the time, showing that they're talking to each other. But basically, if you were to go through here and you wanted to change the genre or whatever it is of any of this music here, it should then reflect on this side. But I've tended to do all of those changes within here, and then it reflects in iTunes. Okay, so look, it's taken a bit of time there to do this, right? I'm just going to cancel it now, just based on time here. But I know that I've already done quite a lot of these things here. So this says missing album artist. Okay, Paul Check. It's going to be the same thing. Change the album artist to the selected songs to the most. Yep. So these are all selected. I could select individual songs, but it's all selected at the moment here, this gray color. So what I'm then going to do is if I click on apply, boom, it's done. But the one thing you really, really need to make sure that you do, please take note of this, is you need to scroll down on here to pending solutions. And in pending solutions, it's sitting there. It's saying, do you really want to do this? Now, when you click on this, commit all solutions, boom, it's done. Because I ended up doing all of this stuff the first time and nothing changed, because that was the one part that you had to do. So I might go through and do the rest of that. But for the purpose of this video, I just want to show you one last thing, or two last things actually. Charts, Amazon Music and Beatport, really popular website for DJs. You can get the top 100 of a ton of different genres, which is epic. So say, for example, I really want to know what's going on in the trance charts. I like trance, I like house. I'm going to bring this up here. And then what you can then do is when it comes up with the top 100 songs, you can click on the top one, the number one song at the moment. Right? I like the song. I could be then like, that's pretty cool. I like that. Let's do it. What I then do, actually, does this do it here? Oh, no, that just goes, it just makes that big screen. Okay. I'm learning as I go too. Goes back to here. If I like this song, I'm going to type in Castles in the Sky Extended Mix. I'm going to do a search for that on Spotify because I get my music downloaded from Spotify. But if you were to go to this button here, this is going to allow you, this button here opens the song or artist on Beatport. You can go there and then you could buy the song there and support the artist from the website, which is pretty awesome. So then you can know what's popular around the world. Last thing, say for example, you make a few different changes here on iTunes and they're not reflecting on BeaTunes. You need to go here to File and you need to go to Synchronize. And then that's going to synchronize the two together. Pretty much in a nutshell, I'm sure there's a gazillion other things on this program that you can do, but they were imperative for me to get my library up and running. So I hope this has helped you. Please feel free to leave some comments below and stuff. I'm not on YouTube all the time, so I'll answer it when I'm available. But yeah, if you've got any other tips or tricks or anything like that that you found that were important for you in setting up your BeaTunes library, then please comment below in the YouTube video. And yeah, enjoy this amazing, amazing program.